Thank you. grab some Oreos.
You'll need about 36.
Either put them in a Ziploc bag or a food processor and crush them. It should look something like this.
Grab about a spoonful to save for later.
Grab about 8 ounces of cream cheese and mix it in. After mixing, it'll look something like this.
Now you'll need a baking sheet and line it with parchment paper.
Roll the mixture into a ball and place it on the sheet.
Make some space in your fridge and leave them in there for about 30 minutes.
Meanwhile, grab another bowl and pour in some white chocolate chips.
Put it in the microwave for about 30 seconds.
Take them out and mix them around and repeat this until they're melted. After 30 minutes, take them out and put them on a stick.
Now they're ready to be dipped in chocolate.
Just like that.
Put them back onto the parchment paper and pour your Oreo crumbs on them. They're gonna end up looking something like this. So yummy.
Put them back into the fridge for 10 more minutes and they're done. Let's try them.
Okay, here we go. To make Oreo balls.
All right, let's do this.
All right, so we're about 20 minutes in, and this is where we're at so far. It's smaller than my hand, and we still got all these, so.
All right, guys, a little update. This is an hour in. That's it. It's as big as my hand.
All right, guys, we are now 2 hours into the rubber band ball. It is looking pretty good. You guys, I've been working on this for so long, it's actually dark now.
I can't believe I just spent 4 hours making this rubber band ball, and in part 2, we're gonna make it twice as big with all these. Let's do it. Since you guys blew up my last video, we are going to attempt to make the world's largest rubber band ball.
All right, guys, we are about an hour in, and it honestly doesn't look like I did anything yet. All right, guys, we are about 2 hours in right now. It is getting really big. We're gonna do a bounce test in there.
We just broke the roof.
All right, guys, it's been 3 hours, and this thing is getting huge. The sun is going down, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to finish in time, but we're gonna try.
4 hours in, and that's all I have left, but it's getting dark.
If this video blows up, I'll go back to Target and buy as many rubber bands as I can buy, and we'll make this thing even bigger in part 3.
Guess what? It's time for another room makeover. This time I'm taking on my daughter's room. She's 13 years old, so I'm gonna give this place a glow up. I'm gonna get really creative, rock what I've got, and hopefully spend under $10. Step one, we're painting this and freshening up this desk. So cute. So much better. Here's my $10 spent.
Oh my gosh, this chair.
So much better. Adding a clear coat. Clorox wipes. Now pencil cup.
Storage bin.
And done.
More storage bins.
Clear storage drawer. Now it's time to clean out this closet. Making progress. Organization complete. Now let's make some plans. For a succulent, draw 5 of these shapes. Cut them out. Trace the shapes on some poster board. Cut and paint. Cut a slit, then glue. Glue leaves in a circle. Roll the smaller leaves to create a center. Here they are done. Before and after. Before, after. Before and after. She loves it.